Welcome to the tutorial on feedback voltage amplifier, also called as series shunt feedback. The series shunt feedback consists of a unilateral open loop amplifier, which is denoted as a circuit, and an ideal voltage sampling and voltage mixing feedback network, which is denoted as the B circuit. The A circuit has an input resistance, which is denoted as Ri, and an open circuit voltage gain, which is denoted as A, and an output resistance denoted as Ro. It is assumed that the source, that is Vs, and the load resistance have been absorbed inside the A circuit. The B circuit does not load the A circuit, that is, connecting the B circuit does not change the value of A circuit. The circuit basically is an ideal circuit that exactly follows the ideal feedback model. So the closed loop voltage gain is given by AF is equal to output voltage by the input voltage, that is Vout by Vs, which is equal to A divided by 1 plus A beta, denoted by equation number 1. AF corresponds to the closed loop gain, A corresponds to the gain of the open circuit amplifier, beta corresponds to the gain of the feedback network, and this RIF corresponds to the input resistance of the complete circuit, and ROF corresponds to the output resistance of the complete circuit. So let us try to draw the equivalent of this particular circuit, because in this tutorial we will try to analyze and find out what is the input resistance and output resistance of the series shunt topology. So the equivalent circuit can be represented in this form, wherein we have the input resistance represented as RIF and the output resistance represented as ROF. The series mixing will result in the difference between Vs and Vf. Because we have a series connection at the input side, the difference between Vs and Vf will result in the input voltage Vi here. And it is reduced by an amount equal to the feedback, which is given by 1 plus A beta. So I can represent the input voltage Vi to be equal to Vs divided by 1 plus A beta, given in equation number 2. And the current, that is the input current, that is represented as Ii, will be equal to the input voltage divided by the input resistance Ri, which will be equal to Vs divided by 1 plus A beta divided by Ri. So this equation number 2 is substituted in this particular case to obtain the equation number 3. And this current is drawn from the source voltage Vs and the input resistance Rif to be equal to Vs by Ii. You can clearly see here Rif is equal to Vs divided by Ii. So we have equation number 4 there. So substituting the equation number 3 in equation number 4, I can compute Rif to be equal to Vs divided by Vs 1 plus A beta into Ri. Or in other words, the input resistance Rif is equal to 1 plus A beta into Ri, which is given by the equation number 5. Therefore, what we observe is that we have a series mixing at the input side, and this series mixing will result in an increase in the amplifier input resistance by a factor which is given by the amount of the feedback factor equal to 1 plus A beta, which is one of the desirable property of the voltage amplifier. Now next we need to determine the output resistance ROF, that is this output resistance ROF. So what we do is we consider the circuit in such a way that we set the input voltage Vs to be equal to 0 and apply a test voltage Vx between the output terminals, and these output terminals are represented as OO dash. So you can see the input SS dash is short circuited and the output you are applying a voltage Vx. If the source Vx produces a current Ix, then the output resistance Rof is equal to Vx by Ix, given by equation number 6. For the output loop, you have Ix to be equal to Vx minus AVi divided by R0. This is by applying the KVL rule. So we name that as equation number 7, and we know that the input voltage Vi is equal to minus Vf, that is denoted as equation number 8. But Vf is beta times V0 that we have seen here. Vf is nothing but beta times V0. So that is equal to beta times Vx now. That is because we have replaced the output voltage with Vx. So what we can say is that Vi will be equal to minus beta times Vx, which is denoted as equation number 9. This equation is just obtained by replacing Vf by beta V0, and beta V0 is replaced by beta Vx. So that is why Vi will be equal to minus beta Vx. Now if you substitute this equation number 9 in equation number 7, we have Ix to be equal to Vx minus A into, this was Vi, so this will be minus beta Vx divided by R0, or Ix is equal to Vx into 1 plus A beta by R0. What is the equation for Rof, that is the output resistance? It is Vx divided by Ix. So if I rearrange this particular equation, I get Rof to be equal to R0 divided by 1 plus beta, that is denoted as equation number 10. So what I can say from this is that we have seen the type of the connection at the output side was a shunt connection. So the shunt connection or the shunt sampling or voltage sampling at the output will result in the decrease in amplifier output resistance by a factor of 1 plus beta, that is the amount of negative feedback, which is again one of the desirable property of the voltage amplifier. So let us conclude this topic by considering the inference. What we have seen is that this circuit is a series shunt circuit or a series shunt feedback topology. So whenever we have series, we will have an increased value of resistance, and whenever it is a shunt connection, we will have a decreased value of resistance. So we have seen a series connection at the input side. So we can see that we obtain an increased value of input resistance, and we have seen that output is a shunt connection which results in the reduction in the output resistance. And if you observe the circuit, we have not actually considered the input resistance with the source resistance RS and the load resistance RL. So that is why if we consider RS, the source resistance, and the load resistance, then our actual value of input and output resistance will be equal to RIF minus RS, and Rout will be equal to 1 divided by 1 by ROF minus 1 by RL. So these equations will come into play only when we have the source resistance and the load resistance specified.